Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. We need to talk about an aspect of the E2 reaction that's this idea called regioselectivity. In organic chemistry, I think there are two important words that begin with R, and one is resonance, and we'll see that a lot in this course, and another is regioselectivity, and that's what we're going to introduce now. In regioselectivity, you have the same process that occurs in a different place in the molecule, a different region of the molecule. So it's how much control or how selective is that process? We talk about its regioselectivity. And this is important for the E2 reaction. So here we have an alkyl halide, secondary halide, and we're gonna react this with a base. We have a strong base in our reaction. And so this strong base is gonna remove a beta hydrogen. Well, here's our halide. There's our alpha carbon attached to the halide. And then we have two beta carbons. And this is our regioselectivity. Which beta carbon will react? Well, as we know, we're not going to react the beta carbon. We're going to react a hydrogen on the beta carbon. So we have two different beta hydrogens. And of course, this carbon has more than one beta hydrogen. But these three are the same. And this one is a second group. Most often, in our typical bases, like methoxide and ethoxide, we get removal of the beta hydrogen on the more highly substituted beta carbon. And so if we follow these arrows, we're going to remove this beta hydrogen. That CH bonding pair is going to become a new pi bond between the alpha and beta carbons, and we lose our leaving group, our bromide. We get a species that looks like this. Now, that beta hydrogen is not always the one that reacts. As it turns out, if we use a base, specifically a very bulky base, and what makes this bulky is T-butoxide has this massive T-butyl group on it. It's very sterically hindered, so this gets into the idea of sterics. Then our base is too bulky to reach this highly hindered beta hydrogen. And so it goes after the beta hydrogen on the less highly substituted beta carbon. But it's the same process. It's still an E2 reaction. It just happens at a different region of the molecule. It's a regioselectivity issue. We attack this beta hydrogen. That bonding pair becomes a new pi bond bonding pair. And we break the CBr bond, and that is our leaving group. And we get this product. These are called regioisomers. And they arise from a regioselectivity issue in this reaction. We actually have names for these products, named after the scientists who discovered them. So the top one is called the Saytseff product. And if you go online, you'll see a lot of different spellings for this. It's actually a Russian scientist, and so translating this name into the Roman alphabet is difficult. But so there are a lot of variations of spelling. The lower product has a name. It's called the Hofmann product. So these are two products that can arise from an E2 reaction. And sometimes we encounter this one. We'll see E2 reactions where we have multiple beta hydrogens. Normally our bases, sodium methoxide, sodium hydroxide, ethoxide, they tend to give us the Saytseff product. But if you're using potassium T-butoxide or T-butoxide as a base, that's a bulky base, and we will get the Hofmann product as the major product instead.